Hello Python programmers, this is AK. In this video, we are going to learn about how to perform the object detection using ImageAI. First of all, the ImageAI is a Python library to empower developers to build applications and systems with self-contained deep learning and computer vision capabilities using a few lines of straightforward code. In this video, I'm going to show you a trial of object detection in ImageAI. So follow this video fully to understand the ImageAI library and concepts that work behind this project. Definitely this video will be an interesting one to learn. Okay, so before starting this video, do like, share, comment, subscribe. It motivates me to produce more good content in Python programming. Okay, so let's start this video. For performing the ImageAI object detection, you have to install certain dependencies, that is TensorFlow, most important for deep learning. And next one is OpenCV, Keras, NumPy. So these libraries are much needed one to perform the ImageAI object detection project. If you want to know about all these packages, we already made so many videos by using these packages. I'm sure that you will not get bored by watching all these project videos. If you have enough time, you can spend some useful time on my videos. Okay. After installing all the packages, you have to install ImageAI. If you already installed ImageAI, no problem. But you have to upgrade that into its latest version. It will be helpful to you to avoid runtime errors. Okay. After installing the ImageAI library, you have to open your notebook. I only prefer Jupyter Notebook to run the code for this project because I already explained why I am choosing Jupyter Notebook in my previous videos. So I don't want to waste your time on that explanations because I am a time saver guy. After installing all the libraries, you have to import the ImageAI library. So from the ImageAI, you need to import the image classification. In this object detection, we have to classify the input images and what this model is going to predict from the input. Okay. And you need to import another library that is called as OS, that means operating system. It is used to walk through the image path and the deep learning model path that we are used to predicting the image. Next, create a variable called execution, and in this variable you have to call the method called as operating system dot get CWD. Basically this method is used to know the current working directory of our process. Next, we are going to declare a variable called detection, and in this variable you have to call the method called image classification. This method is used to detect the input images that we are going to give. And next step is, you have to set the deep learning model type that you are going to use in your prediction. For that process, you have to call the previous variable, and in this variable, you have to set the type of deep learning model that we are going to use in the next step. There are so many deep learning models are available. We are using a ResNet 50 type model in our project. And then we have to set the model path. You need to know one thing before the next step. That is, you have to insert all your project files like main execution Python file, deep learning model and the input image in the same path. Which means you have to insert these files in your execution path, and that will be easier for the program execution. After giving the deep learning model type, we have to download the deep learning model for predicting the input image. So create an instance called detection.setModelPath, and inside this object pass the parameters like execution path and your deep learning model. So don't worry guys, I will put a drive link in the description for downloading the deep learning model file. It will be around 100 MB. And one more thing is, it is a pre-trained model, and if you want to customize your data model, you can easily customize that by using this library. By using ImageAI, we can easily customize our own data. Generally, it takes high amount of GPU while processing the deep learning model. I already faced that kind of situation in my final year project, and that is a different story about it. Next step is very simple one to do. You have to create a variable called detections percentage probabilities. So the probabilities means it actually taking some parameters to guess the input image, and it will show the image percentage in it. Using that values, we can easily judge what kind of image actually present in the input image. Okay. You can easily understand once you see the output values. Now we need to give the path to the input image. So type prediction.classify image. inside this object you have to set the input image path, and you need to pass another parameter, that is your result count. Result count simplifies how many results need to print in your output screen. Here the results are predictions. You are actually setting how many predictions that you want to print on your screen. Next, we are going to indexing the predictions on our screen. So I use for loop to list down the prediction values. And that's all about the code. Now just run the program. It shows some prediction values. Basically, this program guesses some things about the test image that I inserted. It shows that this image 90% is used to be a pot and 1.8% is used to be a cauldron. Cauldron is actually a kind of pot, okay. It shows other predictions also, but it stands to be less in input image. I already said in the previous part, if the guess percentage is high, you can easily set that the percentage value is used to be a original image. So I reveal the original image, you can easily find out the model's accuracy by seeing it. Once you see this image, we can easily judge the image. The image is actually a pot with some plantations. This one is a simple trial of object detection. I'm currently working on more projects and running deep learning models on my system. I will be back with more tutorials about image AI. So if you want those tutorials, kindly subscribe our channel and do like, share. It will be helpful for me. Okay. So that's all about this video. Thanks for watching and thank you. See you on next video.